Welcome, welcome. I'm today dropping my monthly reading for August 2013. And I want to wish happy birthday to the Leos and the Virgos in the house. Happy birthday. Yes, yes. Positive with the light of the sun, grandfather's sun here. Leo is ruled by the sun. But this month is another month all charged up here, my friends. We've got some serious stuff. I'm having to write notes because I'm just can't keep it all together. But definitely we have a new moon in Leo also coming the August 6th here. And Leo's all about that creative energy. And he, it's like the I will do this, okay? So we're going to follow our hearts. That's where we're going to go from now on. We're definitely going to be coming from the heart. That's all I can say. It's time. The alignments are here. These gateways and portals are opening. We were talking about transformation. Then we were talking about initiation. The initiation has begun, my friends. So it's time to get on board and go for that love, courage, and abundance of peace. Peace to the planet is what we have to say, okay? And it's also about self-love, too. And we've been talking about that. Believe in yourself. Start taking care of yourself. I'm now starting a new little series of, I'm calling it Stretch and Touch. It's a circulatory workout. I've been wanting to get shape, and I just decided to do it for myself, and exercising, you know, by myself can get boring, but now doing the videos has motivated me, and the fifth one I did this morning, so, and I'm feeling good about it. I'm feeling toned, I'm getting these tired of the wiggle jiggles, you know. I'm only going to wiggle the toes from here on out, and it's all so important. The feet, my friends, we're going to talk more about that too. We got a detox from the feet up, coming out from the heart, okay? All right, and I just took some notes for myself. Oh, and then Venus goes into Libra, and Libra is an air sign, and that's on August 16th, which is, you know, it's all about Venus right now, my friends, also. Venus, and Venus also rules Taurus, too. Remember, we talk about in the constellation Taurus, his third eye is the star, that giant red star, Aldebaran. And you should follow that star, too. And Sirius, star Sirius is also sending, it's called the Lionsgate. Just so much stuff. I mean, like, if I don't write it down, it's just, and there's another a time frame where I think it's August 11th through the 24th, or the 24th, I should have written it down correctly, but there's another cardinal cross with Libra, Capricorn, and Aries. I mean, just a wave of energies. It's just courageous time for the people like us who want to see our planet heal harmoniously. We are the ones who's going to take it to that next direction. We are the ones. Okay, and because of this Leo energy here, I did want to open up. I brought out the angel tarot cards, but I've only brought out the court cards and the major arcana, okay? Then I brought out my dragon tarot because of the fire energy involved with this Leo sign. So I brought out my dragons, and again, the same thing. I'm only using the major arcana and the court cards for that. And then from my dragon deck, this is the sun card. And if you can see, it's a beautiful place. There's only two cards in the deck that has lions depicted, and it's the sun card and also the strength, number 8 card. They highlighted Leo in the lion in that image too. And if it comes out, that'll be cool too. But this is the card for the sun, and just to read it for a moment here, it's number 19 is the sun card. The sun, in the form of a lion's head, surmounted by the zodiac through which it passes, rests on the body of a red fire dragon. In turn, the fire dragon rests upon the disc of yin and yang, symbol of eternal change. To one side, we see the outline of Stonehenge, and Stonehenge is right here in the bottom, Stonehenge. And we're familiar with that in the UK. Stonehenge, an ancient monument built by humans as a cosmic calendar. On the lion's forehead, we see the runic symbol Sigil, which literally means the sun. And if you see here, right here, that sign is this rune. Now, here they are, let me hold both. Here they're calling it Sigil, but in my book of runes, it's known as Sahuelo, okay? But it's all about wholeness. And so I'll open up with reading this, and then on my last, I will pick up to close the reading with this rune, Sahuelo, okay? And you see Sahuelo. Can you see that? Okay, Sahuelo. And I picked it back in 2011, December 5. But it's about wholeness. Let's see if I can hold them both up here so you can see what the rune looks like with the card. Okay. And wholeness, life force, the sun's energy. Sahuelo stands for wholeness, that which our nature requires. It embodies the impulse towards self-realization and indicates the path you must follow, not from ulterior motives, but from the core of your individuality. Seeking after wholeness is the spiritual warrior's quest. And I had just highlighted on my Facebook page that I consider myself a spiritual warrior. So I think some of you also, I'm just trying to hold this so you can see it, but it's kind of, but I believe, my dears, this is where we're all, that's the initiation, spiritual warriors, that's what we're going to become. And yet what we are striving to become in actuality is what by nature you already are. Become conscious of your essence and bring it into form. Express it in a creative way. A rune of great power, making life force available to you. Sahuelo marks a time for regeneration down to the cellular level. And remember when in the last month's reading for the month, we were, I think I, the topic was rewiring, reprogramming ourselves, okay? So we are regenerating down to the cellular level. Although this rune has no reverse position, there is reason for caution. You may see fit to withdraw or even to retreat in the face of a pressing situation, especially if events or people are demanding that you expend your energy now. Know that such a retreat is a retreat in strength, a voyage inward for centering, for balance. Timely retreat is among the skills of the spiritual warrior. Sahuelo counsels opening yourself up, letting the light into a part of your life that has been secret, shut away. To accomplish this may call for profound recognition, for admitting to yourself something that you have long denied. There is a prayer known as Gayatri, G-A-Y-A-T-R-I, Gayatri, that embodies the spirit of the rune of wholeness. Address the sun in this fashion. You who are the source of all power, whose rays illuminate the world, illuminate also my heart so that it too can do your work. And I'll just hold up the book real quick here because I know that by memory. I wrote it down here moons ago, and I wrote it, I recite it from memory when I look up to the solar rays. While reciting the Gayatri, visualize the sun's rays streaming forth into the world, entering your heart, then streaming out from your heart center and back into the world. This is a powerful and life-enhancing prayer, and I swear it is, my friends. It truly is. That, and thank you, Jesus. Those are powerful, powerful. There is caution here not to give yourself airs. Even in a time of bountiful energy, you are required to face and vanquish your refusal to let right action flow through you. Nourish this capacity, for it is a mark of true humility. Practice the art of doing without doing. Aim yourself truly and then maintain your aim without manipulative effort. Meditate on Christ's words. I can of my own self do nothing. John 5:30. For by our own power we do nothing. Even in loving, it is love that loves through us. This way of thinking and being integrates new energies and permits us to flow into wholeness, which is the ultimate goal of the spiritual warrior. Very good. And here I wrote down, and look, a note I just did in 2013. We want to lead and initiate a new outlook of love from our heart. That's what I wrote on this blue paper. We want to lead, initiate. But this one, practice the art of doing without doing, adaptability and skillful means. You who are the source of all power, whose rays illuminate the world, illuminate also my heart so that it too can do your work. Wait for the universe to act. We do without doing and everything gets done. Okay, and the universe is acting. It's showing the signs. These planetary alignments are hoochie mama excited. Okay, I'm putting the sun card back in the deck and I'm putting Sahuelo back in here. Now this is two sets of runes, by the way, if you're ever wondering. I have two books because I wore the first one out, it's not intact. So, but anyway, so we're going to do that 9-card reading, and let's get started, my friends, okay? So I'm going to pick, let's see how we're going to do this. I think I'll pick 4 from the angels. And 4 and 1. Okay? All right, my dears. Let's get aligned here. Take a deep breath. Inhale. Exhale. And start, think about your heart and the sun. You speak that prayer. I'll type it at the end so you can have it. It's a short one and it's a wonderful prayer. Okay, exhale and sit comfortably. Remember, it's all about body alignment. That's what my new routines are about. Just trying to circulate the body and get our alignment. Our spine is so important, and our feet too. The nerves down there affect so many different organs in our body. Dragon cards, 4 to make 8, and the last one, 9. Okay, and then I'll pick the last ring at the very end, okay? Alrighty. Okay, let's begin the reading. Unity, Archangel Sandalphon comes out. Traditional viewpoints or methods, spiritual organizations, seek out mentors and like-minded friends. Well, there we go. We've got the Hierophant here. Okay. Very good. And we know that in the typical, sometimes they say it's like symbolizes the Pope, but it's about that conviction and, money, because, it's the Pope, sort of has that traditional religious background, but yet works with you know, his government, he aligns with them. But yes, okay, but here we're just reading traditional viewpoints or methods, spiritual organizations, seek out mentors and like-minded friends. Okay, well, that's always a positive thing, right? Because when we talk about things like this, we want to hopefully embrace the people who are into it. King of Coins, we do have a coin card here, and that's about, you know, money and things like that. Alrighty, and we've got the King, very good. This is a wonderful card too. You know, the Kings, they're all great cards. You know, they rule the kingdom here. They rule their people, and hopefully, you know, it's a good welcome to have a king that you respect. So this is what we want. But we see some money coming through here, and I love this card, how they have him looking with his royalty, and you can see there's a treasure down here. You know how dragons love their treasures too. They're kind of like the mermaids. They like to find hidden treasures. Okay. Oh, my favorite card in the whole deck. The Golden Dragon Chariot card. How cool. Oh my God. Yes, and I love this card. Very good. Number 7. And this is Cancer, the glyph for Cancer. So it's the chariot's ruled by Cancer. Very good. But this is all about that determination, that psychic effort to maintain your emotional equilibrium. It's about the balance. You see here, he's the Golden Dragon is harnessing both two other dragons down there. One that usually are depicted by two horses, a black horse and a white horse, because each one wants to go their different way, but you have to know how to balance that energy. But the Golden Dragon, very rare if you're into dragon lore. Beautiful. It's my favorite card in the dragon deck. That one right there. Triumph and victory. Triumph and a victory. Very good. We have another queen. Well, we have a queen now come through. Oh, and a queen of earth. So we've got the king of earth. And now the queen of earth have come together. So we do have a collaborative moment here. That is super, super cool. Thoughtful, creative, warm, sensible. Make time for those around you. Take a sensible approach. Deal with challenges in a kind and understanding manner. Very good. Well, most of the queens are, you know, very calm and serene. Queen of Swords might be a little more on that testy side, tenacious way. But again, they rule with empathy is how they rule. Queen of Cups especially. She is the empath. Very good. Well, we've got dinero, plata, money in the house. Let's see what is coming through. Queen of Fire, just speaking of Chiki, because she's my favorite, actually. Well, the Queen of Cups. Oh, the Cups are my favorite signs because of my sun sign is Pisces. But for some reason, I do align with the Queen of Fire. Confident, warm, intelligent, graceful. Stretch your wings and fly, exclamation mark. Don't underestimate yourself. Assert your independence and creativity. Well, there we go, my friends. That's what we're doing. Every day, try to think of something that you like to do and make it in a creative way. Actually, I got I'm going to drop my new moon video tomorrow, but I found some more beads, some puka shells, and I'm going to make a new necklace. So I'll show you all the pieces, and then I'll... So that's going to be one of my creative projects besides me getting back in shape. Ooh, and the High Priestess, my favorite girlfriend, of course. As a Pisces sun, the moon rules the Pisces. The High Priestess is Luna. Luna's best friend. Yes, yes, yes. Beautiful. And you see how she's up. She's doing an alchemy there with rainbow colors because that's the color of Luna. The rainbow colors of her minerals of the moon surface. The Galileo spacecraft from NASA has taken awesome images of Luna and her rainbow colors. So If you have a chance, Google on that. But, you know, this is about dreams, imagination, introspection, psychic, mystic. I love her, and I love the mystic. He wanted to come up. See how people, I get so excited. I just do. But look at that. Highlighting the introduction to the Sun card, and the Sun card comes out himself. Well, I'll just read it real quick because it's right here again. The Sun in the form of a lion's head, surmounted by the zodiac through which it passes, rests on the body of a red fire dragon. And yes, there's the dragon here. See, this is the dragon's head, and his wings are right there around the beautiful. I find this picture captivating. You see how the Sun, he highlights all the zodiac, because he's grandfather's son. He's in charge. He demands, right? Male energy. In turn, the fire dragon rests upon the disc of yin and yang, symbol of eternal change. To one side, we see the outline of Stonehenge, an ancient monument built by humans as a cosmic calendar. On the lion's forehead, we see the runic symbol Sawelo, which literally means the sun. But here they call it Sigo, which I'll have to investigate that. My personal self, I've never heard of a rune named Sigo, but you know, these are Viking runes, which they're all the same, these glyphs. And again, I totally believe these glyphs come from that high intelligence. And here we have the magician to bring us home. Very wonderful. And this card number one, you know, all about that energy. Okay, and this is ruled by Mercury too. You are ready, exclamation mark. You have the resources or the ability to manifest them. Life is magical. And that's what we're doing with this Sun power in Leo here. We're going to manifest, especially with this new moon in Leo. This is the time. Look how this is opening, my friend. So tomorrow I will deliver a video just with all this, and with these energies aligned for this month of August, okay? Beautiful. We are ready. You are ready. You have the resources and the ability to manifest. Life is magical. Wonderful. Wow, that's a great... great feeling, okay, and I'm just going to pick one rune for the closing here. Very good, and here is the rune selected. Okay, well, I can tell that this is a reversed rune because it's heading down where that way. I'm pretty sure it's supposed to go up, but let me get to the book here. Okay, Ophila is this rune's name. Okay. And this has to do with separation, but I picked it like that, if I'm correct. I think this is how I picked it. My, I don't want to rewind right now. I don't want to. I think I did pick it like that. So separation, so that means it's a reversed reading, but it has a different message. So we're going to read the one I think was what I first picked out. Okay, and this is called also separation. Separation. So let us see. Separation. Okay. And the rune's name is Ophila, and it's separation, retreat, inheritance. But I did pick it reversed. I'm sorry, I'm just trying to hold everything up here. So separation, retreat, inheritance. And they were just saying, you know, if you feel that there's a time for retreat, go within, my friends. Okay. It's all about you right now. Self-love. And the reverse reading. This is not a time to be bound by old conditioning, old authority. Consider not only what will benefit you, but what will benefit others, and act according to the light you possess now in your life. Because you may be called upon to undertake a radical departure from old ways. Wow. Check this out, my friends. What a reverse. Sometimes I don't like to see them, but this is awesome. Because you may be called upon to undertake a radical departure from old ways, total honesty is required. Otherwise, through negligence or refusal to see clearly, you may cause pain to others and damage to yourself. Adaptability and skillful means are the methods to cultivate at this time, and still you must wait for the universe to act. Receiving this rune, remember, We do without doing, and everything gets done. Interesting. Interesting, interesting. And back in the day, I wrote for this card on 12/11, wait on the will of heaven. Can you see that? Wait on the will of heaven. So that's what we're doing. We're going to wait for the universe to align us with its messages. Wow, I liked it. And just to pick up these cards first from Doreen Virtues, we had the Sandalphon coming through as the Hierophant there. We've got the Queen of Gems, Earth, Coins, coming through with being warm and sensible and creative. Look at there. There's that word. That's what Leo's all about, creative. We've got the Queen of Fire, who gives us that spirit, that action to go forward and be confident, warm, intelligent, and graceful. And then the Magician, Archangel Raziel. You are ready. You have the resources and the ability to manifest them. Life is magical, magical. And if anybody knows about magic, it would be the Magician. Very cool, very cool. And then for the Dragon cards, look at these two. Awesome, awesome. The Golden Dragon here. And I'll just read from, because he's real short with here with his messages. And then the High Priestess came through and the King of Coins. Okay, so it came through this way, but the Chariot. This is a nice reading, my friends. Very nice. Very nice. Okay, and the Hierophant. We'll highlight one at a time. The Hierophant. Oh, well, we did the Hierophant. No, the Hierophant was from that deck. I apologize here. The Chariot is what I'm trying to get to here. Okay, the Chariot. We'll highlight the Chariot. A beautiful and rare golden dragon is drawn across the landscape by two other dragons. From the way in which the two attendant dragons are looking intently at the ground, we can guess that they are looking for something or someone. We cannot be fully sure in what element we find ourselves here. Example, whether water or air. At the base, we see a crab lurking behind some rocks. Well, you know, we know that the crab, the Cancer, is a water sign. So I believe it'd be water. Okay, looking down at the water. But this is wonderful. The golden rare dragon came through. And then we have number two, High Priestess. And the High Priestess, you know, and the Magician came out too. And the Magician is number one. Then comes our High Priestess, number two. The High Priestess stands between the two pillars of secret knowledge and initiation. She is the guardian of things hidden and intuitive. Above her, the symbol of the moon. In her hand, she holds the Torah. So written in the magical alphabet of the runes. Get down. Oh my goodness, I didn't even know that. For this image that she's holding. Well, I'm glad I brought up my runes. Confirmation how psychically things come together synchronistically. She is holding a Torah so written in the magical alphabet of the runes. Above on the one side the earth. While on the upper right, the symbol of yin and yang, again yin and yang here, indicating that the universe is a constant state of change. Before her, we see a great cauldron, reminding us of her association with witchcraft. And I was smoking in my little cauldron earlier today too, via my dragon. It's now gone out there a little bit, but that's good. So we're aligning with the energies from the mystic. From one of her hands, a rainbow descends into the melting pot, symbolic of the seven levels of initiation that each of us must eventually undergo. And that's what we're saying. I totally believe the initiation has begun. It has begun. It's not that the initiation will begin. It has begun. Wonderful. And again, we highlight it. So we got to get working with our chakras too, my friends. The chakras are importante. And the Sun card, beautiful. Love, 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 love. Mucho, mucho kisses. And the King of Coins will read what they say about the King of Coins and the King of Coins, a man at the top of his trade or profession. Very good. He knows how to bring home the bacon, baby. But we're not gender related here. We women can be kings too, especially if you own your own business. That's how the cards of destiny work, actually. Okay, my friends, even though this was reversed, it told us what we needed to know. Okay, keep moving, keep focused, move forward, be creative this month, get outdoors, feel that sunshine in your light. On your face, that sun's rays of light and love in your face, okay? And it's the energies are here. Okay, my friend, we'll talk to you soon. Mañana, new moon in Leo. Ciao.